Welcome to our staff engagement dashboard in Power BI Desktop. Today we will create this nice looking dashboard from Excel-based staff engagement survey data. We will prepare the Excel data, transform the data in Power Query, including unpivoting columns, and create some new columns as well. And then we will use that data to design this dashboard. So stay tuned with us, and let's go. This data was shared by one of our subscribers, which contains staff engagement statistics from various regional offices of an organization. Whenever we get data like this, the first thing we do is to combine all data on one sheet. If there are too many sheets or files, data is combined using some automated tool. However, since we have few sheets with small amount of data, we will simply copy and paste the data on a single sheet. We will then use this sheet to prepare our Power BI reports and analysis. After bringing all the data on one sheet, we can add another column for regions. This column will help us summarize data by regions. Click on the Excel workbook button to import the data into the Power BI and create a dashboard using this data. In the Navigator window, select the sheet where you have combined all data and press Load. Wait for the data to be loaded into the data pane. And here is the table and its fields in the data pane, which you can use to create reports and dashboards. Now, go to the query editor and transform this data. We need all percentages in one column so that we could filter and summarize them, which we cannot do in current structure. So select all 6 percentage columns and go to the Transform tab. Here, click on the Unpivot button to combine these columns into one. Rename the Attribute column to Measure, and then change the Data Type of Value column to Percentage. After making all the changes and transformation, click on the Close and Apply button to load the transformed data into the data pane. Add a gauge visual and select value field as data. Change it from sum to average. Then, insert the measure field to filters and select the learn and growth measure only. Rename the value field to learn and growth. After renaming the value field, place the visual at the bottom left corner of the page. Make a copy of this visual and place it next to the existing one. Change the filter from Learn and Growth to Work Life Balance, and rename the value field to Work Life Balance as well. Repeat this step for each measure. Create a copy of Gauge Visual for each measure and change the filter to that measure, and then rename their value field accordingly. Keep doing this till you have 6 gauge visuals for all 6 measures. Now, go to the table view and change all values to percentages. This will automatically set the maximum value of each gauge visual to 100%. Currently, you are viewing the global averages. We can display these statistics for each region. To do so, we need to insert a slicer and add the region field to its data area. Place this visual at the top right corner of the report. You can now display all statistics by region as well. Use the Control key to select multiple regions. We can also display headcount here using a card visual. Insert a card visual and add the headcount field to the card visual. It shows 23,000 total headcount, whereas total headcount actually is around 12,000. Which we can confirm from the Excel-based data. This is because the head count is repeating with each measure, so each head count is repeating 6 times. We can correct this issue by going to the data table and adding a column for actual head count. We just need to divide the head count column by 6, which is the number of measures we unpivoted, and the times head count is repeating itself. Don't worry about the decimal places, they will disappear when data is summarized. Now, go back to the report and replace the headcount field with the actual headcount field. Rename the actual headcount field to headcount. Remove the filters to display the global data. And you can see that the total headcount is now correctly displayed, matching with the Excel data. Insert a picture of an employee to depict the headcount and place it above the headcount card. Insert a slicer to your dashboard and add the measure field to the slicer. Insert a column chart to your dashboard and add the value field to the y-axis. Change it to average instead of sum. To display region-wise statistics, add the region field to the x-axis of the column chart. Rename the value field in the y-axis to measure. Now you can select one or many measures from the measure slicer to display in this column chart and compare various regions. However, we don't want this slicer to filter the gauge visuals. Therefore, we will go to the Format tab, enable the Edit Interactions, and then remove interactions on all gauge visuals while the measure slicer is selected. Now, when we will select a specific measure, the gauge visuals for other measures will not disappear. We will do the same with the region measure, so that when a region is selected in the region measure, other regions do not disappear from the column chart. This is perfect now, as everything is working as it should. Now, insert a text box to your dashboard and add an appropriate title for your report. Finally, select all visuals except the image and the headcount card. Go to the formatting and turn on visual border. Also set the rounded corner to 5px. Add a text box visual and place it over the image and the headcount card, covering them entirely. Turn on its visual border and set the rounded corners to 5px. Select the text box, go to the Format tab, and use the Send Backward button to send it behind the image and the headcount card. Resize the image and the card to fit inside the text box without hiding its borders. Great, our dashboard is now complete. With this, we end our tutorial today. Thanks for sharing the data and watching our tutorials. We hope you liked this tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.